What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Bwear Bassin coming at you again with another one. Today we are fishing the Willamette at Willamette Park, looking for some smallmouth. Now we got a cold front coming in, so it's kind of already here, but we're gonna have rain for like the next 5 days. So I figured that I better get out here and do some fishing. Water clarity looks way nicer than it's looked. Not a lot of boats out here running around. There are a couple that are starting to chalk up the water. I'm gonna throw jerkbait and probably some bottom baits, curly tail, grubs, craws, stuff like that, and the good old drop shot. So we're gonna see if we can find it. We're gonna fish this spot and a couple other spots down the way. We got a lot of time to kill today and a lot of fish to catch. So I'm gonna try to get out here and get to it. I got my gloves on, got my GoPro strapped on, and I got 3 rods with me. I'm packing heavy today. Spinning rod and 2 bait casters. So without further ado, guys, let's get to it. All right, so I tied on a curly tail grub. I turned on a jig head with a white curly tail grub. I want to tell you guys something. As a bank angler, man, knowing I'm gonna come fish these rocky spots and all this stuff, and I'm searching for fish. I'm not yet catching them. I'm still searching for these smallies on the river. I go out and I buy the Cabela's brand jig heads with no keepers on them because they're cheaper. And you get 25 of them for like, I don't know, $3.75 or something like that. So that way, when I do lose them, it's not that big of a deal. I can lose as many as I want. I'm gonna just lose that curly tail grub. That's the biggest part about it. But curly tail grubs aren't super expensive. They'll still catch the fish. They'll still hook the fish. Don't get me wrong. Don't let any tension off them, but it's just a good way to make sure that you're not losing a ton of money. And sorry about all this wind interference, guys. I know you guys are gonna have to listen to it and deal with it. The rain's starting to push in. It's gonna push in here soon. I mean, that won't stop us from finishing out fishing, but these are 3/8 of an ounce jig heads. Throwing this on, 7-3 to 1, 13 fishing TX, much heavier rod than I need. I think this is a heavy, or maybe a medium heavy. Nah, it's definitely a heavy. with 16 pound Seaguar. Red label. Let's see if we can he was 12 feet off the shoreline. The fish had jumped down there. But like, that's all mud. A little bit farther down, once you get down another 20 feet, it all turns into mud until you get pretty far out there. It makes me wonder if they're just down there chilling on that mud flat. Just keep taking a couple steps, taking a cast, taking a couple steps, taking a cast, until I get down as far as I want to be, and I'll turn around, go back. Really trying to chuck this thing out there as far as I possibly can. Oh, there was a hit. You could tell that was a hit by the way it was. How did he miss it though? How? Yeah, you can see it in the tail of the bait, actually. I mean, we're getting hits. They're just not sticking. It's the third hit in 15 minutes. Oh, I got him. I got one. What do I got? Is that a carp? Oh, it's a pike minnow. Well, he's warm too. That takes off the skunk. Not gonna kill him. I'm gonna let him free. I know. Be mad at me. Cool little pike minnow. Cool little fish. He smoked it though. I told you there's fish out here sitting on this flat. I think these might all just be pike minnow sitting on this muddy flat. He smoked it. I had to catch up to him. I don't think he wanted to be hooked the way he jumped. It's a good sign. That fish was nice and warm too. Really good sign. But I barely had him hooked. We'll be right back. Fish. That's a good one too, guys, right there. Got another pike minnow. Just a pike minnow kind of day.
To the B side.